Well, good evening, everyone. It is time for a little more Wild Arms. So I guess let's get started. So if you recall, last time we fought a boss at the top of Mount Zenom, and of course the statue that we were trying to protect got destroyed. Kind of expected. Happens a lot in RPGs like this. So we'll make our way down, head back to the Baskar village. Oh, that's great. Let's try this then. Why not? Not healed, dang it. How about that? Didn't work. Still hurts. So if Jack doesn't learn from the hint, he'll just attack regularly. Which is not so bad. He does have the highest attack power, base attack power of the three characters, so Rudy's a little higher up now because I bought that new weapon for him. That was mostly useless. There's a crest graph. Okay. What else have we got going on here? Oh, that was kind of weird. Look, did you see that glitch out? Doesn't matter. Now, I'm pretty sure that there's a few places that I didn't actually get to in here. So I'll have to do a little bit of exploring on the way out. Still nothing. He did it! Meteor dive. Oh, he's still up. Amazing. Now this is where, yeah. Okay, so I think it was one level below this where there's a... Wow, that's a lot of enemies. Oh, you know what it probably is? I think I can deal with this. Hold on. So what may be happening is that I'm walking around as Jack and his luck may be really low, which is why we're getting such high, encounter rate. So if I switch characters, maybe I can speed things up a little bit. We'll try that when we get out of the battle. Because frankly, these guys aren't particularly difficult. they're only providing cursory experience in Gela also, so let's check this out. Yeah, his luck's bad, good, worst. So we'll switch over to Rudy for a little while. But wait, is this the way up? See, that's the problem with stopping the dungeon and taking 2 days off, basically. Totally unnecessary critical hit. Two damage. Good work, Cecilia. Gonna get you a better staff. Maybe put a nail in the one that you have. Oh, I guess it wasn't a useless thing, because apparently neither of the main characters with actual melee abilities can do enough damage to take out a hobgoblin in one hit, so that's interesting. They still have ointment. Don't ask about the ointment. Now, I'm getting the feeling this is the wrong way. Oh yeah, totally. We'll go back. Oh, it wasn't a mini-boss before? That's completely unexpected. Well, let's heal Cecilia. She'll need it. Assuming that this thing doesn't kill her in one shot, it does not. Good. Good damage, but not great. It's probably not worth it in general. That didn't do anything. Still didn't do anything. So I'm remembering now that the summon power is dependent on magic capabilities, so naturally Rudy and Jack are not particularly savvy there. I don't know what to do. Yeah, whatever. We didn't. It looked like we got him. Did nothing. Was it critical? This should do damage. That's damage. Oops, dang it. Come on. Well, that's interesting. The stuff stays gone, but returns if I save and load the game. Okay, interesting. Good to know. see what we got going on here. Things that shows up in later Wild Arms games is the ability to have a starting level of force points at the start of each battle. For instance, in the later games, what generally happens is, since force points are allocated between 0 and 100, you basically get as many force points as your level at the start of each battle. So, in this game that doesn't happen, which is kind of sad, but that's the way the cookie crumbles. Sell some of these heat salves when we get back to town. This is ridiculous. Like, we will never use that many. Cecilia with defense takes more damage from a hit of a hobgoblin than Jack does without defense. So they really don't mess around. I mean, each character has strengths and weaknesses, and they're pretty prominent in this game. That's interesting. What's over here? Is it just the puzzle that I used to open the door to the next space? Probably. Beating on Jack, look at that. we didn't go up these stairs. Sigh. Peace! All that's up here is a single treasure chest, but it's a secret sign, which I think this is the first one we've gotten in this game. What does a secret sign do? It reduces a fast draw's consumption by 1 MP. Well, Sonic Buster it is. Come on. So basically what you do is you use these secret scrolls to reduce Jack's MP consumption, because he never gets a lot of MP. The goal will be to figure out what attacks of his we use the most, and make them the most efficient to use. With Cecilia, as she levels up, she'll get a lot more MP, so less of a problem there. Wait, what? What does this do? Does this do what I think it does? No, it does not. Okay, so I have to use it preemptively on a character that's going to get magic cast on them. That's what I suppose that means? Okay. And, you know, having not played this for a long time, it really is pretty amazing how, well, that's interesting. It's pretty amazing how much the later games innovated. We'll have to spend some time on one of those at some point in the future. Because this one's just kind of a solid but basic RPG. All the later ones did a lot of neat stuff. Fortunately, I think we'll have the cash to upgrade our weapons and armor a little bit once we get back to town. That'll be nice. We kind of bare bones this one. A little bit. Wait. Christ. Cutscene. Probably sell some of the old armor and stuff if we're not gonna use it. Care of that. Now let's buy some stuff. So we know that we want to up her attack power a bit, so let's do that. And we know that everybody should get fresh armor as soon as possible. And I guess we can afford a Vorpal Razor for him, so I guess they misspelled Vorpal. Sell back the other stuff. All right. Then let's, so far so good. Also, let's, I guess while we have it, the cash, we may as well up our possession level for each of these items to 10, while we can. Like this day. Normal, normal, and worst. So now we need to head to St. Centour and Port Timney. So they gave us a Kizim Fire. With that we can turn on the teleporters that will get us around the world for the next chunk of the game. Looks like they're all saying the same stuff again. Yeah, alright, fine. We'll just move on then. There we are. Blending a sci-fi and fantasy that really makes the Wild Arms universe so fun to go through. It's like, oh yeah, there's just a mirror satellite that we bounce off of. Pure information. Flying halfway across the world. So we need to find the holy statue and protect it. for that. Oh, yeah, dude. That's a little creepy. Oh. Even more barren. The Dragon makes, isn't it? Or was it Kraid? That sound was used in Super Metroid. Isn't gonna work very well. I didn't think it was gonna work too well, but yeah. Oh wow. Centour. Not Centaur. Centour. If you can just put something in your pocket. I shouldn't have jumped so fast to buy stuff, because there's gonna be another upward level of and now we can't afford this upgrade because dang it. Well, We'll do stuff in the same order. Kind of ironic, I should have caught that. We need to make some magic. Ooh. Everybody seems to really be interested in Calamity Jane. So water and ice are the same in this game. Out of crest graphs. Yeah, these lost alien ancient technologies, I tells ya. Just springing up all over the place. Ah, right. Oops. Yeah, so she says something different to everybody. Sounds like a quest. Has 3 hit points left. So here's another L pyramid. Can take it, but I think it might cause us to die. That is to say, the next set of enemies will show up. I don't know. Does it let us go? May have suspected that we need a new tool to do that, so we'll get that eventually, I guess. Now, there's a question, is there a town here? Oh. Port Timney. So this was the other town that was mentioned. I think. These are the same weapons and armor, so that's at least a small amount of, what's the word I'm looking for? It suggests that we aren't going to be completely out of date here as far as items and stuff like that. So this, the world in this game has kind of a... Gaze of Death. Great. That sounds like a wonderful place. A chance to do what? Duplicator. So duplicators are the magic keys in the Wild Arms universe. They can open any magically closed door once. He prefers the term treasure hunter. I don't even want to know what that implies. Yep, already got it. So yeah, the structure of the world is pretty similar to the original Final Fantasy. There's an inner sea, and then there's an outer sea. And right now, if we want access to the inner sea, we'll need to, We will need to, we'll need to get a ship. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. Monsters are trouble on the high seas as well. He's very sensitive about it. Hey, there's the statue. We can't get to it. Pass. Well, what do we want to do first? The Maze of Death or the, I wonder if that's our only choice. Well, let's think for a minute. Wait, can I... There we go. So this is just a peninsula that stops. Not sure if there's anything I can do about it. I'll avoid the sand for the time being. Whoa. Okay. What do we got? We know that Jack can kill critters, and Those guys are weak against Holy, so we'll analyze this guy instead. Ugh. Whoa! It's level 12 and it does that much damage? Wow. Weakness water. Alright, well, we can deal with that. Freeze. Whoa, it's not enough. Watch out for those tail moves, guys, because they're pretty difficult. There's nothing here except that maze of death. But there should be another L pyramid somewhere, shouldn't there? Maybe there's only one here to make it a closed loop, basically. To leave it as an open loop until I get a ship. Antlion, huh? That's not so bad. That's good defense, though. See, it's crazy. Their levels are really low, but they're actually pretty tough. We can win. Alright, we can deal with that. Amount of cash. Not gonna complain. Okay, so here's another L pyramid. I think. Can I? Yes. Ha 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 ha! Let's see where this one takes us. Eventually we'll get attacked by enemies that kill us. Actually, I probably should stop while I'm ahead, huh? Oh! Ha ha! They got us, right? One duplicator needed to enter, one needed to leave. There's the other L pyramid. And we'll probably need the duplicator from said Centaur in order to get there. Alright, well. We've done a little exploring. We've fought some interesting enemies. But we're nearing the 1 hour mark, so I think I'll probably call it for tonight once I get to the next save point. And, we'll take on some dungeons next time. We need to conquer this cage tower, and then we need to take care of the maze of death. And by doing that, hopefully we'll do something interesting. We'll see. To call it a night. Thank you for watching, and I will see you all next time.